Ladies and gentlemen of the internet, welcome. So we're here today with Drake, Kanye West, Lil Wayne, and Eminem in Forever, a song that I've actually not heard in quite literally forever. About 10 years since I last heard the song. Why am I doing this song? Usually I don't react to things that I obviously already know, I've heard before, or you know, whatnot, or seen before. This is obviously not the case. As I just said, I've heard this like 10 years ago. I haven't listened to it in 10 years, but probably the second the beat starts, I can probably like reminisce the lyrics on the spot, because I used to listen to the song so often that like once I'm hit with it, you know, like all the memories and all the lyrics will probably start coming back immediately. But the reason why I'm starting with this is because we're actually going to do a lot more of the more traditional artists on the channel. And I thought, what better way to start than something like Forever, which has four artists that are relatively, you know, mainstream, but also artists that I've not heard music from in like the last 9 years. So it's kind of perfect, you know. So for this month, give or take, you know, next, not so much the month in terms of the month of July, but rather for the next 30 days after this video comes out, whenever this comes out, not every day, of course, but like in the next 30 days or so, we're going to be doing a lot of one of the four artists. I haven't decided which one yet. I think I'm going to start with Eminem. We're going to do a lot of Eminem over the next 30 days, and then maybe we'll do, you know, Lil Wayne afterwards for the next 30 days. Maybe then, you know, we'll do Kanye for the next 30 days. Actually, with Kanye, I haven't heard any of his songs really, besides Stronger and Power. I don't, and obviously,
She Take My Money.
And I say, what's this actual? It's not called. It's called Gold Digger. Might be called Gold Digger. I was trying to think of like what the actual lyrics it was, but what the actual name of the song was. But I think it might just be called Gold Digger. But with Kanye, I've just basically not heard any of his songs, if I'm being completely honest. Then you've got Drake, who I've heard quite a few songs. Lil Wayne. Of all the artists, probably Eminem. I mean, not just probably Eminem's definitely the artist that I've heard the most of. You know, most of his albums, not all of them, most of his albums. You know, some of his very early albums I haven't heard, and some of his very early features I haven't heard. But in general, I've heard like up to like 10 years ago. You know, most of the songs that he's released, you know, give or take around 10 years ago, I stopped listening to him. Same with Lil Wayne. Carter 1, Carter 2, Carter 3, Carter 4 was the last thing that I heard. Is Carter 5, I think? I'm not actually sure. But yeah, you know, we're going to have a lot of fun time. Obviously, there are other artists as well that I want to eventually like listen to. But I thought this is the perfect way to start. So with that said, if you want to watch the original video, because I'm going to be pausing a lot during this video, as I always do. So if you want to watch the original video, if you're not here for a reaction, but rather you're here to listen to the music, you know, make a decision. If that's really what you're here for, just to listen to the music, then that's not for you. That's not a place for you. If you're here for a reaction, so you can stay here. But just be warned, I do pause quite a lot. So I will have the link for the original video in the description down below, so you guys can just hop over to the original video. And with that said, let's get ready to rock and roll. Yeah, immediately, I already know how it goes again. Oh, okay, yeah, y'all are gonna be shocked by my Drake, not my Drake impression, my Lil Wayne impression. It may not mean nothing to y'all. I always thought my Drake and Lil Wayne impression was great, until people told me it wasn't. It broke my heart, because I thought, yeah, last name ever. We'll get there. We'll get there. We'll get there, and y'all can tell me whether that my impressions are good or not. See, now that I've watched some basketball in like the last 2 months, I actually know who that person is now. Wow. Wow. 10 years later.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all.
The way Eminem disappeared there, everyone is like, yo, I look it so cool. Eminem's just like,
last name ever, first name greatest, like a sprained ankle, boy. Started off local,
but thanks to all the haters, I'm G4 pilots on a first name basis. Let's go. In your city, faded off the ground. Nino, she insists she got more class.
We know. Swimming in the money, come and find me.
Nemo.
If I was at the club, you know I balled. Chemo, drop the mixtape, that shit.
I mean, it even says LeBron. My goodness, was I an idiot 10 years ago? But I didn't care about basketball. I didn't know about basketball until like 2 months ago when I started betting on basketball. So that's the only reason why I'm familiar with basketball, all right? All right? Look, I live in the UK. Basketball started like 12:30, all right? So is that something that I would have ever watched? Football, on the other hand. Proper football, I'm talking about, not, you know, hand egg. Football, on the other hand. Oh my, I'm making myself popular today. Football, on the other hand. You can ask me any question, I'll answer anything.
If I was at the club, you know I balled. Chemo, drop the mixtape, that shit sounded like an album.
Who'd have thought a countrywide tour be the outcome? Drake is such a crazy style. Like
everybody wanted a deal, and I did it without one. Yeah. Nigga, I'm about my business. Killing all these rappers, you would swear I had a hit list. Everyone who doubted me is asking for forgiveness. If you ain't been a part of this, at least they got the witness.
Like, I've never listened to a Drake song, even when I was younger. I never listened to a Drake song. I was impressed with his lyrics. Never, right? Never, not once. But you listen to something like Headlines, and I don't know how that goes. I just know that. You just listen to that, and you're like, this guy's flow. It's not even just his flow, it's his style. Some people just have a certain style. It's not even their flow, it's just a certain style that is just so strong that they don't even need to say much, and it's just so strong. Like, you look at someone like Lil Wayne is a perfect example of that. But Lil Wayne has the lyrics, but he's got such a pronounced style that you're just listening, you're like, whoa, you know immediately when it's Lil Wayne. You know, you look at Amelie. Ah, oh, there's so many great songs, man. But like, you know, it's just such a pronounced style. One second. We've got Kanye next.
Ever Mr. West is in the building. Ain't no question, you like the kids. I have all dreams.
Big chain. I stuck my neck until the bitch came and went all fall like the ball teams. Just so I can make it rain all spring. Y'all seen my story, my glory. Mama just comes in and I don't know what my coat is right now, but I've got the exact. Yeah, the exact same cup. Mama just comes in like the ball teams, just so I can make it rain all spring. Y'all seen my story, my glory. I had raped the game young. You call it statues. When a nigga blow up, they gon' build statues from me. I like Kanye's West verse here, like the second half of it, so much. Oh, money, Benjamin Button. This part right from here onwards. I need to listen to Kanye. Trade the Grammys back just to have my granny back. Like a fanny pack. Chasing star, I'ma turn into a maniac. All the way in Hollywood, and I can't even act. They pull their cameras out and got Danny snap. I used to want this shit forever. Y'all can have it back. Like that second part, I don't know what it is about Kanye, but the thing with Kanye is, right, I haven't listened to it, his songs at all. So like, let me know your recommendations for Kanye music, because again, I'm a blank canvas basically. Besides Gold Digger, Power, is it Power? Power and Stronger. I think that's the one. Power is the one that was in Saints Row, right? That's why I know it, because it was in Saints Row and Stronger were again. Okay, everyone knows that song. Yeah, that's Power there. But he's just got like, Kanye's got this arrogance, right? I've got arrogance to myself as well. You know, like, maybe for me, I think it's more so confidence. But he's got arrogance. So when he actually talks about, you know, the more human side of things, I kind of like that a lot about him. So that's why I like the second half of his verse so much. It's just a simple line about, you know, I trade my Grammy plaques just to get my Grammy. To me, that line, it's just a simple line, but it's just, it tells you a lot about how this person can be sometimes. Now we've gotten to Lil Wayne. Oh no! Actually, that would definitely not be Lil Wayne. The guy's just chilling, like, yeah.
Okay, hello, it's the Martian, Space Jam Jordans. I want this shit better. Make up and smell the car.
I used to listen to him all the time, man. Literally all the like day in, day out. You know what, man? Fucking wild how hooked I was on his music. And just like then immediately just like stopped listening to it. Same with like Eminem. Same with rap. I literally just dropped it overnight. Was listening to like Lupe Fiasco going to back then. What was I going to school? And then like just one day I was like, okay, I'm done with rap. Never listen to it again. And until recently, I just came back. I was like, you know what? Listen to it again. But I used to be obsessed with it.
Okay. Hello, it's the Martian. Space Jam Gardens. I won't dish it forever. Wake up and smell the garden. Fresher than the harvest. Step up to the target. If I have one. Then I guess I'm just New Orleans. And I will never stop. Like I'm running from the cops. Hopped up in my car and told my chauffeur to the top. Life is such a fucking roller coaster.
The beat is... Yeah, the beat is so fucking fire, though. The beat is so fucking fire. It's just like very, it's very simple, but that's what makes it great because it just lets the people on the beat just shine. And they've got the little jingle as well. They ding, 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 ding. Hopped up in my car and told my chauffeur to the top.
Life is such a fucking roller coaster, then it drops. But what should I scream for? This is my feedback. Ding, ding. Pistol on my side, he don't wanna hear that thing talk. Let the king talk, check the price and pay attention. Little Wayne, that's what they gotta say.
If there wasn't stuff on my piano right now, I'd replicate that. Which Little Wayne, that's what they gotta say. I'm like Nevada in the middle. I'm always a sucker for these little parts, you know, that are just so easily missed. I'm always a sucker for them. That's what they got. I'm like Nevada in the middle of the summer. I'm resting in the lead. I need a pillow in a cover. My foot's sleeping on my gas. My right. And now we of course get to Eminem. Right? Sorry. You know what? We're doing it properly. We're doing it properly. All right, we are doing it properly. We're doing it properly. Yeah, you thought I was gonna wear it, eh? No, none of that. None of this anymore, right? None of that anymore. We're doing this. We're doing it properly. I don't have a hoodie near me right now. That's fine. Ah, this looks stupid. Man just came in there like, flexing. The thing that I like about Eminem is like his creativity. It's not his style. It's not his flow. It's his creativity. It really is. With Eminem, it's his creativity, right? Because he's got so many different styles that I can't really pinpoint a style. I know people hate Recovery. Well, they don't hate Recovery. They think it's Eminem at his worst. And there are some people that think Recovery is his best album. There are some people that think that Recovery is his worst album. I personally... In terms of look, we'll save that for the end, right? I'm gonna talk about Eminem a little because I think this is gonna be the month of Eminem. I think this is gonna be the month of Eminem for the next 30 days or so. We're gonna be listening to a bunch of Eminem songs.
No. Back in stadiums, the shady spits his flow. Nuts that go macadamian. They go to ballistic, bro. He can make them look like bozos. He's wondering if he should spit this slow. Fuck no, go for broke. His cup just runneth over, oh no. He ain't had him a boss like this since the last time that he overdosed. They've been waiting patiently for Pinocchio to poke his nose. Back in the game, as they know, rapping to be the same as before. Fashion in the brains of souls. And establishing a name as he goes. The passion in the plan is ignited. You can't cut it out, love be lighted. This shit is exactly what the fuck that I'm talking about when we riot. You dealing with a few true villains who stand inside of the booze who's spilling and spit true feelings until I took them.
Sorry, but you know damn well I'm here to point out the jingle. The story about the song is great as well. Like, apparently, you know, Eminem's verse was so good that Kanye and Lil Wayne went back to the drawing board and rewrote their verse. I don't know how true that is, but I think that's what the story used to be, right? And I don't know whether it's ever been confirmed or anything of that sort, but hey, I'd believe it. Because Eminem comes in with fire. Like, everyone else, I feel like, was just kind of calm and collected. You know, there weren't really any bars. Funny enough, I'd say, nah, Lil Wayne did have the most bars. I was going to say, like, funny enough, I think Drake had the most bars, which is just not like him at all. But Lil Wayne definitely had the most bars. And then Eminem comes in, and you're just like, okay, bars after bars. And you're just like, bro, when does it stop with this madman? When does it stop? But I don't think he's got the same swagger as the other people. I think he came in this one with a point to prove, because I think this was like after his relapse, after his hiatus, I'm not 100% sure. But this was after a break regardless, so he came in there with a point to prove, and you can definitely tell that. You know, everyone's got this like, chilled out, you know, we're making money, we're having fun, everything's going well, and then when it comes in, well, no, I've got a point to prove, right? I need to tell people that I'm back. I am back. So, you know, everyone is just like sitting there on the couch, except Kanye West. Kanye West is standing up there like, I know you see Eminem. Eminem just with his hoodie. Back in stadiums, his shady spits his flow. Nuts to go. Macadamian, they go so ballistic, whoa. He can make them look like bozos. He's wondering if he should... Like, Eminem sounds like he's about to fight someone. As he always does. Not always. Sometimes this. I love that line. I love that line so... I don't know. Every time I listen to the song, that's my favorite line for some reason. It's a stupid line, but it's one of my favorite lines.
That he overdosed. They've been waiting patiently for Pinocchio to poke.
I mean, he literally just said it. Yeah. So, what was I saying about hiatus or, you know, whatnot? Well, he literally just says it.
They've been waiting patiently for Pinocchio to poke his nose. Back into the game and they know rap will be the same as before. Passion and embraces his soul. With establishing a name as he goes. And a few things the flames ain't ignited. You can put it out once we light it. This is exactly what the fuck that I'm talking about when we riot. You dealing with a few true villains who stand inside of the booth, true spilling and spit true feelings.
Nah. You dealing with a few true villains who stand inside of the booth, true spilling and spit true feelings until our true feelings come flying up out of our mouths. Never mind it. Payback, motherfucker. Ah. The way he just kind of like just goes off. I mean, obviously it's easy to imitate, right? It's easy to like just listen to it and be like, okay, I can do that. I can do that. But like, actually, to come up with that, it would be crazy, wouldn't it? I'm like the last person that you should ask about that, but it's crazy, right? You can't put it out once we light it. This shit is exactly what the fuck that I'm talking about when we riot. You dealing with a few true villains who stand inside of the booth, true spilling and spit true feelings until our true feelings come flying about our mouths, never mind it. I can't even replicate that. How's it taste? When I slap the taste out of your mouth with the bass so loud that it shakes the place. I'm Hannibal Lecter, so just in case you're thinking of saving face. Yeah, I have no face to save, but I'm telling you, I'm doing this place so great. That line is great as well. I'm Hannibal Lecter. Ah.
You're gonna have no face to save. By the time I'm through with this place, so Drake. It may not mean nothing to y'all. Understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this shit forever. What instrument is that? A trumpet?
I'm actually not sure. I mean nothing to y'all. Understand nothing was done. I think it might be a trumpet, right? So I don't plan. It's definitely a brass instrument, unless my hearing completely fails me, which it could. I don't have a perfect pitch. I mean, that wouldn't help me in that regard anyway.
So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this shit forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Yeah, that's definitely a trumpet, just like very short breaths. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Forever. I did want to talk about Eminem a little bit there at the end, but I might as well extend that to all of them. the ones that I can at least talk about, which Kanye West obviously is not part of. But let's talk a little bit about Eminem here, because I already started that discussion earlier. The thing about Eminem so much is that he's got such a diverse style. And, look, alright? In terms of, we were talking about relapse versus recovery and so on and so forth earlier. Recovery was the thing that made me an Eminem fan. It was like the first, I mean, I listened to his songs before that, don't get me wrong, right? I listened to his songs actually while I was very, very young. I think one of the earliest songs I've ever heard, actually not one of the earliest songs, but one of the earliest songs I've ever had on an MP3 player, you know? There were like three songs I always had on my MP3 player. On my very first MP3 players, I had only three songs on it for a good while, right? And those three songs were Whitney Houston, I Will Always Love You. The second song was Akon featuring Eminem, Smack That. Ah, that's bringing back memories now. And then the third one was 50 Cent was it In the Club? I think it was In the Club, 50 Cent In the Club. I'm not 100% sure. It was a 50 Cent song. It was either that or Lollipop? Yeah, I think it was Lollipop or In the Club. Back then I was like, oh, just a Lollipop. Oh. But then I was like, wait. Oh. Like, oh, okay. I get what you're saying now. Oh. But that was my innocent, like, 7 year old, 7, 8, or 9 year old, you know, self didn't understand it that well. And the thing I like about Eminem is his versatility and his insane creativity. It's not so much his style, because obviously he's been shifting styles a lot. So, like, you know, there's definitely something that I very, very much prefer. You've got your high octane ones, like one of my favorite songs of all time. Obviously, it's Toy Soldier. The reason why I'm saying obviously is because I think almost everyone, you know, has that very high up in their list, and that's a very, very mellow Eminem style. Another song that I very much like is "Sing for the Moment." That song to me was always, at one point, it was his best song. But then you've got like other songs that I really, really like that don't sound like those two songs that I just mentioned at all. You've got My Darling, which I think is probably one of his most underrated songs. I used to listen to that for about a good 4 months every single day while walking to school, right? My school wasn't that far away. I mean, I haven't really moved places, so it's still not that far away. But I used to listen to My Darling, I don't ever want you to leave me, my darling. You and me will be forever together, my darling. And that song. And obviously there used to be a lot of discussion about that song as well, is he confirming the Illuminati? Is that what it's about? Or is he talking about drugs? Is he talking about his personal battle? Is he talking about Slim Shady compared to Eminem? And there were so many people going on and on, like, oh no, it's this and that. Personally, I never really cared, if I'm being completely honest. All these, like, secret organizations and Illuminati and shit and so on, it used to be quite big when I was, like, 13 or so. When I was, like, 13 to, like, 16, you know, and all these songs, Drake, I don't listen to Kanye, so I can't really say Kanye. But Drake, Lil Wayne, and Eminem were just, like, everywhere, you know, YMCMB was everywhere, so on and so forth. People always just say, oh, the Illuminati, it's real, they're gonna come for you, a new world order. I was just like, who gives a fuck, honestly? Like, because like, I like conspiracy theory. I always like conspiracy theories. Conspiracy theories, all right? So I was a lot more into conspiracy theories than a lot of my other friends when I was much younger. And then, like, by the time I got out of them, people got into them with, like, the music thing. Like, Illuminati, I was like, bro, you're, like, 3 years too late, bro. I don't even care about them anymore. Well, give me something new. And so, like, when they were like, oh, the Illuminati, that's what it is. You know, the triangle. I can't even, how do you do a triangle? Like, isn't that just a tri-beam? Like, Kikuho! Tien's, but, like, you know, when that was going on, I was just like, eh, doesn't bother me. I mean, are they a secret organization? Absolutely. Is there an Illuminati? I don't know. And honestly, I don't really care. It's at this point now, it's 2021. What do I care what people do in their spare time? Yeah, there's always this talk about, oh, they can influence you. Project MK. Oh, they're trying to, like, get into your mind with their music. Oh, ho, ho. I'm like, bro, my mind is already warped. My mind is already flipped, all right? My mind is a gutter. Nobody can get into that. you kind of just sink into it, but then you can't escape. You can't influence anything. You just get stuck. That's kind of how my mind is. It's just a massive jumbo liar mess, all right? But yeah, Eminem has a lot of my favorite songs. Like, I used to love Lose Yourself a lot as well, until I didn't. Yeah, that's one of the few songs that, like, I grew out of, I guess you could say, or I stopped liking as much, because it used to be everywhere, so, like, I stopped listening to it as much, you know. I used to watch 8 Mile quite a lot. Everybody from the 313, put your hands up and follow me. Yeah, from the 313, put your hands up. Look, hands up. Notice that this man did not have his hands up, because Free Will got the gas down. Now, who's afraid of the big bad wolf? 1, 2, 3, to the 4. 1 pack, 2 pack, 3 pack, 4. 4 pack, 3 pack, 2 pack, 1. Your pack, no pack, his pack, none. Something like that. I'm probably completely wrong. Probably completely wrong, alright? I'm probably thinking of something else here right now. But yeah, I mean, Eminem for me, he's got the most diverse album. He's got the most diverse songs. You've got some songs that are just kind of stupid, and I like them because they're stupid. And I've got some songs that are insanely emotional. Maybe emotional. I'm not here sitting here and crying or anything. But I, like, you know, he puts his emotion on his sleeve, and he just spews what is on his mind. And he's like, whoa, where's this crazy dude coming? Where is that crazy guy? And who is this guy? And sometimes you just think, who is this guy? And where is that guy? You know, so it's just kind of one of those things. Actually, you know who he reminds you of? Or more so, someone else reminds you of him. 6 Seconds. Obviously, you know, quite big on Twitch as well as YouTube. He's got the same side as well, where, like, he just makes stupid videos sometimes. Like, just, you know, absolutely just fooling around. And the next second, he's, like, opening up his hand. He's like, whoa, where did this come from? You just like both sides of him, you know? Whatever kind of music he makes, you're just kind of like, yeah, kind of, this is what I like. Lil Wayne, let's talk about Lil Wayne a little bit. Lil Wayne, my goodness, man. Lil Wayne is a gem. So many quotable lines. I mean, Eminem has the layers, right? But Lil Wayne, he just has the lines. Like, you can just pick any of his songs, take like 5 seconds of them, and then just quote that, you know, in your graduation speech, and they will think, wow, this guy's a genius. They'll think that you are a genius for quoting that, because, you know, but he has so many stupid lines as well. Real G's move in silence like lasagnas? No. no, stop it. Get some help. Drake, as I already said, he's just got this swagger, you know. I never listened to him before, like, you know, intricate wordplay, intricate lyricism. I listen to him for the flow. Literally, just the style, not even the flow. It's the style, all right? That's what I came here for. And that's what I like. And Lil Wayne, and Kanye West, I can't say much on, because I've only listened to 3 of his songs, so I'm, you know, not qualified. But I do like, you know, his attitude in both, in Power, Stronger, as well as Gold Digger. It's kind of like this fun vibing attitude, but I know he's not he's not like that in his other songs as well. From what I've heard, his other songs are kind of just, actually, I don't know what his other songs are like. Like, I know of one other song. I haven't heard it. I think it's called College Dropout. I don't know if it's an album or a song. Is he the one that had, like, the fat suit or something going on? I'm actually not sure about that as well. Like, I'm sure I probably have heard other Kanye West songs, but, like, none, you know, to any, like, big degree besides those three that I mentioned. Now, with that said, ladies and gentlemen, that was explicit. Not explicit. That was the explicit version of Forever. And, yeah, that's my reaction to it. I will see all of you in the next one, everyone. Until then, hopefully YouTube doesn't take this down, but with almost absolute certainty, they will. With almost absolute certainty, they will. So maybe this video won't ever see the day of light, but I had a ton of fun doing it anyway. So, listening to, even if it's not on YouTube, even if I can't upload this, yeah, I've had a ton of fun. So regardless of that, regardless, you know, my day is made. With that said, I'll see all of you in the next one. Until then, have a nice day. Peace out and bye.